we are going to start a section which is very, very important, right? It's probably as important as you can say electrostats or entire magnetism together. And usually it gets ignored, and the reason for ignoring anything is what?
Easy.
It's easy. First thing is, it's easy, you take it for granted, you're like, okay, so we'll do it at the end. But that end never comes. So at the end, when you try to do it quickly, you will not be able to do it properly. Fine. But then what happens if you do it like this? You lose out on some of the easy questions which you can solve at any level, mains or advanced, at any level, you'll be able to solve modern physics question very quickly. Fine. Because the concepts are not so heavy or involved. Fine. So we'll not do that mistake. We will not wait till the very end to finish this chapter. Fine. We'll start early this section, modern physics. Fine. So modern physics, let's write down. Why it is called modern physics is because the classical physics, okay? Because the classical physics, which is developed by Newton, Galileo, and various other scientists, Faraday, and whatever, like Nikola Tesla and everyone, they, whatever concept they have developed, those were not sufficient to explain what is going on at some level. Like, for example, if you study what is going on inside the atom, if you study the behavior of electron, you will not be able to fully understand what is going on if you try to understand it based on the laws which are developed by Newton, Galileo, and other people. Fine. So there need to be a different set of rules or laws which should be developed to understand what is going on. Are you getting it? So you may think that science is a very structured, physics is a very structured science, but it is not. For like day-to-day things or things which you can easily observe, there's a classical physics to deal with it. For objects that move with the speed of light, there's a relativity you have to take into consideration. Fine. For objects which are very, very small, you have to use a different physics called quantum physics to study that. Fine. So physics is a very unstructured science. Fine. Similarly, here also in modern physics, this is a set of situations where you cannot understand what is going on using classical physics. So that is why a different set of rules are developed, and this is what is called modern physics. Although the name is modern physics, but I think more than 100 years are done when quantum physics was first introduced. Fine. So modern physics, we will be learning few of the things which are beyond our common observations. Fine. So this entire section, modern physics, is divided into three chapters in our syllabus right now. The first chapter is dual nature of radiation and matter. In this chapter, you will learn wave nature of particle and particle nature of wave. See, for a wave, we have till now a basic understanding that wave is nothing but it's a disturbance, right? It's an energy. But first time we'll be learning wave as if it is a particle. Particle and wave are two different kinds of concepts. But now we'll be studying wave as if it is a particle, and not only that, we'll be studying particle, the mass, as a wave in this chapter. Till now we have learned in class 11, you have this laws of motion, work by energy, kinematics, there where we have learned extensively about how a particle behaves, fine. But we never thought of, can a particle be a wave? That is what we are going to do. Next is atoms. See, in this chapter, we are, I mean, similar chapter might be there in chemistry also, atomic structure. Fine. The chapter, the content is very, very similar, just that here we are more into physical aspects of it. In atoms chapter, we are first talking about the structure of it, okay, without getting into the hybridization part of it, which is there in the chemistry, alright. Then we are introducing Bohr's model to understand the behavior of electron in a hydrogen or hydrogen like atom. Fine. Bohr's model is required because the model put forward by Newton was not sufficient to understand what is going on. Fine. So we'll be discussing this. But when you get into detail of this chapter, at the end of the day, this chapter is all about electrons. Fine. We'll be talking about electrons, excited state, ground state energy, excited state energy, how much wavelength it emits, and things like that. So our focus is electron, although the name of the chapter is atoms. Fine. The last section or the last chapter from in this is nuclei. In nuclei chapter, our focus is nucleus. Fine. Nucleus, the reactions it undergo. Fine. There can be spontaneous reactions. Like in chemical reactions also, we have dealt with spontaneous reactions, right? Isn't it? What is the difference between chemical reaction and this reaction?
Chemical reaction involves exchange or sharing of the
electrons. Here nucleus takes part in the reaction. That is why we call it nuclear reactions. Fine. The spontaneous reaction is usually a decay, which we call radioactive decay. Fine. So there is a section which talks about radioactive decay. And then there is a section which is non-spontaneous reaction. These are fission and fusion. Fine. So this is a broad outline of entire modern physics. Fine. More or less, 15%, 10 to 15% should be the weightage of this chapter of entire modern physics. Alright. And another thing is that you can combine modern physics with classical physics. You can fine, electron comes out and then you have applied a magnetic field and then it moves in a circle, you can imagine so many other things. So since it can get combined easily with mechanics, so more than 15% weightage can also be assigned to it. And good thing is, very easy, alright, but not so easy that you can just ignore it till the very end. Right? So we'll take today this chapter, dual nature of radiation and matter. The chapter name is big, I'll just write dual nature. Okay, it is understood. Fine, so now, in this chapter, of course, there will not be a systematic study because people never assume that there will be a particle nature of wave or wave nature of particle. Fine, it was incidental. They never thought that, they have to study particle nature of wave or wave nature of particle. So they were conducting several experiments and out of accident, it came out that wave can behave like a particle, fine. And since the chapter itself is based on several experiments and incidents, so we'll talk about what all those incidents that have led to the conclusion that there is a dual nature of particle as well as wave. So the first experiment was from Hertz. See, initially you will not be able to appreciate the dual nature of radiation, fine. But then slowly and slowly you will gain that, this understanding that you will not be able to explain the behavior. Whatever is getting observed can be explained by, cannot be explained by Newton's laws of motion, fine. So let's see what are those experiments, right? So our first study is actually the particle nature of wave, right? So we are studying particle nature of wave, right? So what Hertz has observed is that if you take a metal plate, what is this metal plate consist of? Free electrons? What does it mean, free electrons? Free electrons are like free to move from one atom to other metal. Sorry, one atom to another atom. So there will be like a sea of electrons that are just floating here and there. Fine. But then they are not coming out of metal. Okay. What Hertz has observed is that if you fall a radiation on the metal surface, okay, then few electrons will be able to come out. Okay. And you can probably capture it if you put a positively charged plate about it. Fine. So this is like the beginning of understanding towards the particle nature of the wave. Fine. So Hertz, you might be using this unit of Hertz with the frequency of the wave, isn't it? So he was doing several experiments with the wave, right? So he just bombarded few radiations on the metal and some charged particles came out. Okay. So this is the understanding that electron can come out of metal. But why they are able to come out of metal? Or first you answer why they were not coming out of metal initially. When suppose you have a metal piece like this, why electrons are not coming out?
Because it's loosely bound.
What do you mean by that? Correct, you can say that. I mean, see, the thing is, if electron comes out, there will be a localized positively charged developed here. Okay, so this electron, if positive charge developed, it will get attracted towards a positive charge and then it get again neutralized. Fine, so it is not a favorable situation for electron to come out of metal. Similarly, for example, you yourself, you are bounded in the earth. You will not be able to leave the earth. If you jump, you will again fall on the earth itself because earth attracts you. Until and unless you get sufficient kinetic energy or you have the escape velocity, then you will be able to leave the earth. Similarly, electrons. Electrons are bounded. But if you give sufficient energy to electron, then electron can escape from the metal. Getting it? Okay. So what electron wants? Energy. Fine. And when you bombard a radiation on the metal surface, this is one of the ways for electrons to gain the energy. And then they are able to come out. Fine. Can you think of any other way to give energy to the electron for them to come out?
Heat.
Heat. Fine. When you heat the surface, few electrons will get energy and they'll be able to come out. And the emission, that kind of emission is called thermionic emission. Thermionic emission happens when you provide energy in the form of heat. Fine. This is called photoelectric emission. The example which we have taken is called photoelectric emission. When you give energy in the form of radiation. Is there any other way to give the energy? Any other way? You can create a huge electric field. Fine? So, if it is due to the electric field, we called it field emission. These are the three kinds of emission. Once Hertz had discovered that electron can come out, then they started finding the ways in which electron can come out. So roughly three ways you can give the energy to the electron and electron will come out. Okay? But the study of this will lead to the conclusion that wave can have particle nature. When you study this in greater detail, photoelectric emission. Why? Because this is where the wave is getting used. And you will not be able to explain how the electron is able to come out if you assume that wave behaves like a wave. Okay? We'll come to that, why it is like this. But right now, you understand, right? Why we are studying photoelectric emission. Because this is where there is an interaction between a wave and the metal. And also, this is the easiest way out of these three to take the electron out. This is very efficient way to give the energy to the electron. Right? So that is why our focus in this chapter is photoelectric emission. And Hertz has conducted first experiment and concluded that if the radiation falls on the metal surface, electrons will come out. Okay. Once Hertz has concluded this, then several other scientists, they have started to study it in a systematic manner. Fine.